Yat e metake api. Welcome back. I'm gonna go for a run right now. It's 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And yes, we're gonna get my workout in. It's late, but we had to go take care of the twins. The twins were up all night and we got up late. So what more can I say? No excuses. Trying to hold myself accountable. That being said, hit that like button right there. Just right there. Don't ignore it. So alright, come on then. Okay, let's go. Answer some questions that I've gotten the past couple of vlogs that if working out is part of my New Year's resolution, my answer is no, it's not. It's always been like this for me. The reason why I always start during January is because some of you might know already my occupation. I work for the Forest Service as a wildland firefighter. So I travel across, wherever they need us in the country. We assist with natural disasters and wildfires. So during the winter times, I'm off. I kind of let myself go. I kind of enjoy myself. It's a cheat day for like 3 months. January is the time when I have to get back in shape, because come February, I go back to work. That's just all I had to share in case everybody was just all curious. I saw a couple of comments coming in like that, so I had to address that. Come February or March, they might be sending us down south to Louisiana or Arkansas, I call it Arkansas, or Florida, down in the Southlands. That's where they have a fire season starts. Around this time of year. So to help them out and assist them, and we swap out guys and crews and engines. So that's just for me to prepare myself, to prepare my body, and I have to get back in shape. So it's about that time of year for me. I'm also gonna share an archive that I've never shared with anybody, or I haven't shared in the past before. It was taken when we went to Arkansas, as I like to call Arkansas, last year. We helped out with some prescribed burns and helped out with wildfires that they had down that way. So hopefully y'all enjoy it. It's a little something. I totally forgot all about this clip, so y'all enjoy it.
A tormented man with a gun in his hand went searching for his wife. When he found her in another's arms, she began to scream and cry. As he put the gun to his own head, said, "It's time for me to die."
Got the Navajo Indian doing what he does best. Dropping a tree down low. Hell of a stump shot on there, Navajo boy.
that's what I do, occupation. Hopefully y'all got a little inside glimpse of what I do. We do a lot of hiking, we do a lot of traveling, and it takes a toll on us, relationship wise, especially with the twins too. It's there's a price with that job, and it does suck to be gone 6 months out of a year at times, but it is what it is. I've been doing this job for about going on 10 years now, going 10 or 11, I think. I started my career back in Arizona. Again, I came up this way. I don't really talk much about my occupation, my job on our channel, just because I try to separate my work life from my personal life. History. That's about 10 or 11 years with the career, and I started off as a hotshot down in Arizona on a hotshot crew. Hotshot crews, if you guys don't know what they are an elite wildland firefighter crew. They operate in areas where other crews would not want to go to. They throw the hotshots into the hottest parts of the fire. And we're in a different location now. We're in the kitchen. I have to clean the dishes because Lakota Bay was a cooking, but one of the twins woke up and wanted his mama, so she's over there taking care of him now, so we swap roles. We love the role play. Just kidding. Like I was saying, I started off as a hotshot, and then I tried another program called Helitech. Helitech is more of a helicopter crew member. You fight fire with a helicopter, and it's pretty cool. You fly a lot all year, pretty much almost all year. You're kind of like the first one on scene when a fire breaks out, and yeah, it's just a few of like three or two guys hold it down unless it gets big and out of control, and then you need to call in a whole crew, you know. So that's what I did down in Arizona, and then me and Lakota Bay, we hooked up, we got together. Then I switched my job from Arizona to South Dakota up here. Then I jumped on another hotshot crew up here in South Dakota in Black Hills. I worked my two seasons on another hotshot crew here. And then I joined a Helitech in the Black Hills. And then now I'm currently with an engine crew for the past 3 years now. Going on 3 or 4 years with the engine crew. But so far so good, you know. That's a little brief history of what I do when I'm not a YouTuber. So y'all will notice, like, during the summertime, whenever I have to go back to work, our channel will slow down with our vlogs, our videos, just because I'll be out of state. I'll be, you know, helping out at work. And Lakota Bay will be alone a lot of times with the kids, so she won't have time to edit or vlog or anything. So just note, be advised. I just want to share that with y'all. I don't mean to talk up about my job, but
alright, we're gonna be closing out this vlog now. Just playing. No, I'm just playing. We're just getting started. We are gonna go to bed though. It's late. It's 11 o'clock. We're tired. We didn't really do much. We just had dinner and pretty much hung out and took care of the kids all evening. Lakota Bay did her. She's doing some work on the computer on her side. So, yeah, we've just been super busy with the kids. Hustling and grinding. See you guys tomorrow morning, 07:00 sharp, 0500. Who knows when I'll be awake. We'll see you guys later.
Welcome back. Just kidding. I'm out here again, gonna go for my early morning run. It's currently 0800, 8 o'clock. And I'm gonna go for a quick run and probably a little short a workout, but yeah, y'all know the drill. Let's do this. One complete round is just over a half a mile. So you run two laps, you know for sure you made a mile, a little over a mile, I should say. Usually you try to run two just because it's so cold out. It's super cold that the cold it kind of gets to your throat. Around this time I just do like 1 mile every day, a mile a day. I mean, of course I take breaks during the weekends. I take breaks on Saturdays and Sundays. I take breaks on those. I don't run, but I watch what I eat, you know, And then I was going to go work out, but that guy right there, not on, he's awake. He was down here already by himself. So when I came in here, I just poked my head in. He's just standing there playing with his cars. So I was like, oh, okay, that's my go time. That's my calling. So I had to come back in and yeah, so it's good enough, you know. My run is good enough. I'm focusing mainly on cardio right now. The weights, the weight training, I do that every now and then whenever I can. Like, I'll probably go back out there and smash the weights once the boys go take a nap. Today we got a whole, I don't know, we're gonna do some things today. We'll bring y'all along. We got some things we gotta prepare for in the next couple of days. So, yeah, I'll be helping out Lakota Bay with that. But we'll see what it brings. We'll see what it brings. Just tag along. Just be the back. Don't be a backseat driver, though. Just
kidding. A whistle, a slick. One, two, three, four. Yeah, that's right. About that time of morning where I went for a run. I sent my morning prayers off to the holy people. And, toshai den ye. That's how you say it. It's I'm making coffee. It's brewing. You're brewing coffee now. You're brewing coffee now. Or without the now, you just say. Or some New Mexican Navajos, they say. So. That means you're making coffee right now as you speak. So for example, right now, coffee is pouring. So I'm telling y'all, ahwe ibej. Ahwe ibej. You're welcome. Navajo word of the day. Ahwe ibej.
I'm at the store right now. I need to get some stuff for breakfast. We kind of don't have some things, so I'm gonna go grab some really quick. The store I'm going to is just right here. So in the spring or summertime, I usually just like walk over to the store on foot, or I ride my bicycle. Since it's cold and all, taking the old boy out. Good job, my war pony. This is the war pony protector, the war pony. This little gas station right here is pretty cool. It has almost everything. Now, we don't got a Walmart. We don't got Bashes or anything. Hey, shit. Common sense. You got to use your common sense every day, people. Just kidding. So, yeah, a little convenience store is pretty easy to go to. In order for us to go to Walmart and all that, the nearest town is a Rapid City, which is about an hour away from here. So yeah, that one just right down the road is pretty easy. It's just right there, and it has pretty much everything that we need. Plain and simple, use your common sense. Well, the kids are out there playing in the snow. They got their snow gear on. Daddy gonna go lift some weights. Like I told y'all, this is what I do. Ugh. This is gonna be fun. While the kids enjoy themselves, Daddy goes and works out. Got the Twindians over here playing in the snow. They love the snow. And enjoying my coffee and hitting some weights, man. Like I said, this is a thing that I love doing. I love staying fit. I love being active. You know, hopefully you guys are doing something that keeps you active as well. It doesn't have to be weightlifting or anything. It's just something that I love to do. Whew. So, all right, I'm gonna get back at it and see you guys later. We're doing a photo shoot here at home for a Valentine's Day.
Lakota Bay is in charge of this. I'm just a helper. We put up this, I guess a backdrop is called, and she ordered this online, and our, it looks nice. It's a picture of a wooden wall, and she's got a floor mat here that looks pretty cool. And so what I'm doing right now, I'm going to iron out. This is an iron gun kind of a deal, or a steam gun. So it steams out all the wrinkles. So that's what I'm doing. Lakota Bay is actually nursing the boys, so she'll be helping me out again here in a bit. So anyways, enough talking. See y'all later.
Did not go according to plan. I did not get any good shots, I don't feel like. If it wasn't the boys, it was my light. My light was acting up. Ugh. So I'm just frustrated. It's not the boys' fault. They don't understand. I know. They're 2 years old. I was just hoping for like one or two good photos for advertisement. So I don't know what to do, if I try again in a bit or just give it up.
Eventually we did do another take with the boys, and let's say it came out great. We got some good shots. Lakota Bay is working on them right now as we speak. She's in her little corner there editing the photos that we took. It was pretty rough from the get-go, but at the end everything all fell in place. So thank you. Thank the gods. So we're going to go end the night here with everybody. This is where everybody road ends. But for us, we're going to keep going. I don't know. Hopefully the boys don't stay up late tonight. They did sleep at a good time today. They took a good nap. So yeah. We'll see you guys on the next vlog. Like and subscribe.